Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, we started at the very beginning of creating animation in the Flame products. So we covered animation concepts and keyframing, and this was all done using the channel sliders in the interface. In this video, you'll start learning about the animation editor and how animation displayed in this visualization will give you total control over your final results. For the purposes of learning, I am using simple graphics in the Action Compositor, but you could be anywhere in Flame using channel sliders and the animation editor. Please feel free to use your own media to follow along. So here I have the simple animation from the previous video. The graphic is moving forward and back horizontally, and if you shift-click the exposition channel to select it, the animation keyframes will appear in the time bar. So you have four keyframes creating the animation over time, and you can see the color indicators in the channel slider as described in the previous video. To see the selected animation as an editable curve, you click the animation button. The channel is automatically framed and remains selected. Please note that if you had not selected the channel prior to switching menus, the channel hierarchy may be collapsed like this, and you would have to manually expand the channels to find what you want, select it, and frame it to the animation editor. So selecting the channel in the slider will save you a bit of time. But another quick tip is if you are looking at the interface and you shift double-click on your channel slider, this will present a much larger view of the animation editor in the viewport. This is fully editable. If you still want to see your images in this layout, you can click the viewer button here and you get a mini viewport. At any point, a swipe to the right of the interface will swap the views around. Now the plan is to animate the rotation of the graphic to match the horizontal movement. Go through the channel hierarchy to locate the ZRotation channel. When you find it, click the channel name to select it. Please note that if you click the value next to the channel, instead of the channel's name, the editor assumes you want to edit this value, therefore a calculator appears straight away. If that happens, just close the pop-up window. Now you should still notice that the exposition curve for the same axis is visible but is deselected. If you didn't want to see this curve, you would collapse the triangle next to the position heading to hide the channel. This is how you can control what curves are visible without turning on channel filtering. Since we want the rotation to match with the horizontal movement, keep it uncollapsed and you'll use the exposition curve as a reference. Now to adjust values in the animation editor, you can click on a value to call up the calculator, or you can click and drag on the value just like a channel slider. Please note that if your viewport only updates when you release the cursor, you can change this behavior by enabling the regen button. The next time you adjust a value, it will update as you drag. Now let's do some keyframing directly in the animation editor. Firstly, the same two methods of creating animation still apply. You can either automate your keyframing with Auto Key, or you can set values and then manually set a keyframe. These buttons are located to the right of the interface. So first off, turn on Auto Key. Now set the first keyframe to 180 degrees. Next, go to the next position keyframe and set the Z rotation to -180 degrees. So AutoKey is creating keyframes as you animate. To show you how it works manually, turn off AutoKey. Go to the next exposition keyframe and set it to 180 degrees. The curve updates, however the keyframe and its tangent are orange. Similar to the channel sliders, you are being told that you have adjusted an animation curve, but you have not yet set an actual keyframe. If you move to another frame or perform another operation, the animation curve will ignore the adjustment and snap to its previous state. So if you are manually keyframing and you want to add this keyframe, you need to click the Set Key button. The keyframe and its tangents turn white, and this keyframe is applied to the curve. Just go to the last frame of the composite and repeat the steps of manually adding a keyframe with a value of minus 180 degrees. If you scrub the time bar, you can review the animation that has been created. Now, when it comes to working the keyframes in the animation editor, you don't need to turn on Auto Key or set a keyframe with each adjustment. You can just pick up the keyframe and move it. As a tip, if you wish to constrain either vertical or horizontal movement, you hold Shift, and the first direction you drag towards will be constrained. So it's very easy to increase a value without affecting time, or change the timing of a keyframe without affecting its value. Now, if you wanted to move more than one keyframe at a time, you can hold Ctrl and drag a box selection around the keyframes. When you click and drag, only the selected keyframes will be affected. The curve color helps you determine when the entire curve is selected versus only a keyframe selection. This becomes important if you want to affect the entire curve or just a single keyframe. We'll discuss this at a later point. However, a very important tip is if you have multiple curves exposed like this, and you draw a box selection across keyframes on multiple curves, any keyframes within the selection, regardless of their curve, will be selected. This can be very useful for moving keyframes on multiple channels. However, this can become tricky if you have lots of keyframes and curves which are close together or even overlap. So to focus solely on one or more channels, you do the following. Select the channel to tell the editor what you'd like to focus on. Next, hold Ctrl F and drag a box selection. Regardless as to what keyframes fall in the box selection, only the keyframes of the highlighted curve will be selected. So during complex animation, you can zone in and focus on a specific curve with its keyframes. Lastly, I would like to mention that it is possible to zoom into specific regions of your animation curve. Similar to a box selection, you hold Alt Z and draw a box around the part of the curve you'd like to view. This zooms into the animation editor, and you can tweak the curve with even more precision. You can also hold Space and pan the animation editor, and if you need to zoom in and out manually, just hold Ctrl Space and drag on the editor. At any point, you can frame the selection or frame all the visible curves in the editor. In the next video on animation, you'll focus on the curve between the keyframes, which we call interpolation, and you'll also get a grip on the handles coming out of some keyframes, which are called tangents. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel and click the bell to be notified for future videos. Thanks for watching and hope to see you soon.